All right, guys, we're back in my garage for another episode of the B58 Digest. If you're new to the channel, I use these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in the B58 community. So if that's something that you're interested in, be sure to subscribe to the channel. There will be a lot more of these videos coming out in the future. So today we're going to talk about the Boot Mode or Pro Tuning Freaks Flex Fuel Kit that has come out. This has finally been released for the B58. Actually, it's been out for a little while now. I know some of you guys have been asking, when am I going to make a video on it? And honestly, with these B58 Digest videos, I just want to make sure that I get a little bit more information and confirmation before making them. So in the past, we've had a little bit of speculation and kind of guessing to try to fill in the blanks on information we don't have. And in the future, I'm hoping that I can do more collaboration with companies so these videos are just more relevant and more useful to you guys. So hopefully you understand the delay. Now, with this kit, I am happy that I waited because it does install differently than the other ones. So most of the Flex Fuel kits and even just the regular ethanol analyzers that we've seen on the market install in the engine bay. So they kind of jump into that low pressure feed line that goes to the high pressure fuel pump. And that way it's easy to install and you can see everything in the engine bay. But that requires running wiring through the firewall to get it into the car. With the boot mode kit, it installs on top of the low pressure fuel pump. So it actually installs just like the older N55 and S55 kits that they've sold in the past. However, it doesn't plug into that low pressure fuel pump module like those kits. You're still going to have to run your wiring to the passenger footwell and wire it into the footwell module in order to get that communication to work. There is something different about our cars, and now that I'm seeing this more and more, I understand why it's wired up the way it is. I know originally when the Dorch Flex Fuel Kit came out, we kind of said that it looked like it was a little bit more cumbersome and difficult to install because you had to take apart the connectors to mess with all the wiring. And it seems like that is actually the best way and the preferred way that all of the companies have found to communicate over CAN to the DME. So that's why everybody wires up to that same module so that they can send the flex fuel data into the DME so that the tune can adjust appropriately. So with this tune setup, you're going to basically have to remove the panels at the bottom lower door sill in order to run the wiring up to the front of the car. That's really the only difference. Now, the good news is they have released instructions about this. It's a little bit hard to find, so I'll have it linked down in the description, but it's on their same, page where they have all of the user guides and other installation manuals for their website. So if you just want a quick link to find that, I'll have it linked down below. You can see all of the pictures and all the instructions on how it installs. Also, Matt over at Ross Racing Performance was one of the early adopters. And if you're in the B58 Facebook groups, you can see some videos that he posted and just a quick review of how quick and easy it was to install and get it all working. So big thanks to Matt for posting all of that. This currently is only for the first gen B58. So if you have an A90 Supra or a G Series like M340i or M440i, then this is not set up to work with your cars yet. Just be patient. They will be working on a new wiring solution for you guys. But again, this was the big reason why it took so long for this kit to come out. The tuners and companies had to find a new way to communicate to our DMEs since it didn't plug in and work the same way as the older cars. So I'm sure that solution will be right around the corner and we'll get some new wiring harnesses set up so they'll have an option for you as well. So yeah, I think this kit is a great option. I know a lot of you guys are already running a boot mode tune, so you really just wanted to use the same boot mode hardware and just have that extra confidence that you know it will all work seamlessly with your software to help the flex fuel tune work. Again, all of them pretty much wire up the same and communicate the same, so any of them will work with your boot mode tune, but this is probably the preferred option for most boot mode users. So that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below.